All right, welcome back to the channel. Thanks for joining again. This video is going to be our bathroom slash get the engine going so we can get this beauty back on the road. But we changed the plan. We're not procrastinating the bathroom.
No.
We've already established that we would never do that. However, we ordered an AC unit and the heat pump combo, and they arrived. They were supposed to take like a week and a half, and they arrived 2 days later after we ordered it. So we're going to go ahead and get that installed today.
Yeah. Plus, it's going to be 90 this week, and so really hot, stinky bathroom, or we could cool it down a little bit with some AC. That might be nice.
Cold, stinky bathroom. That's okay. Way better.
I'll take it.
Yeah.
So, we can fill in our hole where our now our skylight is, and we'll eliminate the need for our tarp every time it is supposed to rain.
And this does not have AC. I got that bomb dropped on me.
Somebody didn't do their homework. I don't know. And let's get to work.
All right, here's the unit. It actually shipped in two separate boxes. So if you order this, this is the outside piece, and then the inside came separate. So look for two. But I wanted to give you a preview of these tires and wheels. So we just got them back. The tire place held them hostage for a minute because their machine was down. But little preview. We don't have them on yet, but they're going to look pretty sweet once they're on.
Oh, super sweet. Let me set the scene for you. We have got to get this box on top of that roof, and we are going to use a ladder that may not work, right? And a ratchet strap. So we're going to tie the box or tie the ratchet strap to the box, drag it up the ladder, and everything's going to go just according to plan. It's about 5:50 p.m. right now, and it is going to take us approximately, I'm going to say 2 hours to get it up there in place. And I don't even know if it's going to work at that point.
I think we're going to be done. I'm giving us some cushion here.
Tomorrow?
We're going to be finished by 7:30.
Okay. She's an optimist. I am possibly a pessimist.
Realist?
I like to call myself a realist, yes.
7:30.
7:30.
Boom. All right. Goal.
And
we're
going to
beat it.
Go.
Pity's sake.
For pity's sake. We're extrapolating.
Extrapolation.
Who's in charge of this?
Hopeless.
Fiasco.
That's the problem.
Oh, my gosh.
Where we want the cranker, right here?
Sure.
The ratchet, we'll call it.
Oh, the cranker.
I just nicknamed it the ratchet.
You nicknamed the cranker the ratchet strap? Gosh.
No, the ratchet.
If only people knew that this happens all the time.
All right, uncrank, ratch over. Where's the middle? Like that.
Okay. Is that where you want it?
Yeah.
Is this where you want to be when Jesus comes back?
Is this where you want to be when Jesus comes back, man? Making fun of poor little Joe Dirt?
Whoa.
That ain't going anywhere.
All right. So I just have to...
You
one,
just
two,
gotta,
three, lift with your back.
One, yeah, one, two, three, clean and jerk.
Clean and jerk. Oh, wait, that went actually pretty well.
Yeah, because it's...
Oh, okay. I mean, if we had a flat ladder... Seriously, there's a big hole behind you, so...
Well, seriously, I know. Hold on now.
I'm ready.
You're going to push me off the other side.
I don't even know what time it is.
Oh, my gosh. What is it stuck on?
It's the ratchet strap. No, 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 no.
No, it's the white
strap. The white strap.
Holy crow.
Oh, yeah, they're hooked. Oh. Hang on, I see it. There. You got it? I have it not. I have it zero.
I know. It's not up here yet.
No, but it's one third math. It's,
okay.
It's halfway.
Success.
All right, so.
Need some better insurance.
Quit stalling.
Quit stalling.
Welcome back to our rooftop. If you didn't see our earlier video, we put on this new rubberized roof coating, Eterna Coat by Blackjack, and it seems actually amazing. So
that remains to be seen.
Remains to be seen. So definitely subscribe so you can see if our roof holds up.
Right.
But we're going to go ahead and open this baby.
Let's do it. You always want to work with tools covered in tar.
I don't know how that happened.
I don't know either. But whenever you go to put it down, it just doesn't want to let go. So that's good. Or you don't want to let go of it.
Oh, sorry. Oh, boy. Okay. Easy open deal.
Well, yeah, somebody was smart when they put this together. Oh,
wow.
Boy.
Look at that.
Oh, my.
Wow, okay. All of a sudden, it's like a stinking windstorm up here.
Right.
I'm chucking that down.
I'm going to. I just wanted to put more stuff in it first. Oh, my goodness.
It should make it freezing in here. My understanding is the heat pump is not exactly like a furnace, but if it's above 40 degrees, your heat pump should work fine for heat. And we'll always, you know, you can have blankets and whatnot too, so.
Yeah, and for us personally, we don't go camping in the winter, like when it's snowing out. I mean, the latest I think we've been is like October up north in Michigan, which it gets cold and you do need some heat, but it's not like you need a roaring fire.
A big roaring flame.
Or anything like that, so should be okay.
All right, so directions, you know,
who needs those?
Yeah, I like to read the directions while he tries to figure things out.
So I completely admit I'm a directions guy. I do.
Are you?
Yes, definitely. I'm a directions guy. Christy is not, which is oddly, you're not
a directions person.
Oh, person, I'm sorry.
What? Are you saying I'm not a directions guy? I mean, what is happening?
I don't know. You're not a directions person, are you?
I read the thing. I mean, well, word for word.
So how is it that I say I'm a directions guy and then you're so shocked at that? No.
I don't think you are. You're stalling so you win this contest about...
Oh, is that what's going on?
Yeah.
Oh, look. Oh, see?
Well, there's this deal.
Well, that's the thing you need. Oh, it's velour.
It is velour. It's beautiful. Direction should be the same with the moving direction of the caravan. So the pointy bit goes toward the front. Ba-ba.
Well, did you bring a screwdriver up?
We brought nothing up. No. Did they give us boards?
How does this come apart? Does it say bring a big hammer?
Are there boards?
You feeling good about this?
How was the other one up?
Doesn't it have pictures?
Do we need to take it apart?
Boards for what?
Okay, so make sure the roof is dry, clean. I mean, we parked it under an oak. No, under a walnut tree.
It's an aspen.
You can tell that it's an aspen tree because of the way it is.
The bolts and stuff are not in that bag.
Just trying to find the hardware for the AC unit, turns out. Glad we got the second box today. They both did not arrive together. We got the AC unit, the exterior portion of it, a couple of days ago. And just today, we got the interior side that has the control panel, the remote, and the mounting hardware.
So what we're finding is there's the directions, and then there's another insert that came separately that has directions for if it has a sealing gasket or if it does not have a sealing gasket. Ours, if you look at the bottom, the gasket is already attached to the AC unit. So we're going to go with the outdoor unit has a sealing gasket, which means we set it over the hole. And then it says fill the self-leveling sealant around the hole in the roof, then set the unit over the hole in the roof. So it's basically saying gloop it down and then set that on.
So this is what we're going to use. This is Dicor lap sealant.
Self-leveling.
Self-leveling.
Ooh.
And this is a life hack. Maybe.
Did it work?
Sort of. Yeah, it did.
The other one chops it clean. So if you ever wondered what that hole was for in your caulk gun.
Right.
Now you know.
Yes. And also, you know what that's for.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Okay. So basically, I just swept around the hole. The sealant's going to go very close up to that hole, and then we set this on.
Here it goes. I imagine a big fat bead, probably.
Yeah.
All right, we calling that good? I mean, is that enough?
I think it looks good.
I think it looks good. What about right there? A little more.
That's perfect.
Perfect. And to take your, keep your cup from overflowing, release the tension on your spring. Just that easy. You ready? One, two, three, hop!
Oh boy.
Come on, get it, get it.
Oh, I should have not worn shorts.
You need to go back towards the back. Okay, all right. Back a little bit more and stop and lower and lower.
It's
oh,
it's hey. Down.
It's doing stuff. Oh boy. All right. Oh, hey, it wasn't too bad. Little minor adjustment here and there.
How bad's it dripping in there?
Oh, it's gonna be a thing. Yeah.
Good.
Rocking and rolling. What time is it? I'm gonna take 15 here.
You're not. It's been 1 hour. All right, in the RV, maybe we went a little overboard with the self-leveling sealant. Only a little drip, but we might have to wipe that up just a hair. I mean, oh boy, here it comes.
Oh boy. Our handy dandy goop tray there.
We have used this putty knife just about more than any tool yet on this remodel or restoration, rebuild.
Revival.
Gosh. I knew it was an R word.
She's new to the show.
I'm new. It's my first day.
It's her first day.
So we're on to this velour beauty. The directions say that there's an up and a down, a left and a right.
Yeah.
Only one way to be connected correctly.
Just put them together and see what happens.
We don't have time to trim. We got 20 minutes left.
Is it 20? Oh, no.
I feel like you've been stalling. Don't look up here.
Right.
All right, so there's three wires coming out of our camper. Three wires on the AC.
Black is hot, white is neutral, green is ground.
Nice song.
Okay. Right.
Done and done.
Done.
Next
and done.
Step.
Neck tabs 1, 2, 3, and 4. So just have to pop those out just a hair. And then you're loosening up your...
your plenum mounting bracket.
That's what you're loosening, yep. That's what I was going to call it, too.
Black thing.
Great. No, I was going to call it the plenum mounting bracket.
I know.
Jeez. Okay.
So yeah, that's going to wind up screwing to that.
Oh, okay. All right.
Okay.
Boom.
You need a hand?
Yeah, I do. And I need bolts.
All right. Pausing.
Okay. Oh, man. Okay.
This could be a while.
Whoa.
Jeez.
You know what I need?
A hand?
A hand.
All right, pausing.
Just for a sec. There it is.
Boom. All right, so now we screw in the other end of this blue thing.
Yeah, what gets those screws? The same type of? Okay.
Quote unquote truss head screws.
Truss heads.
All right, that's going in. I'm going to read the directions and come back with the next step.
All right. The plenum assembly. This has your control panel and a cord. And your other cord is up here in the overhead compartment. And there it is. Yay. Look at you go. Oh, it's got stuff all on the connector.
I don't want to say what time it is, but I think we...
Did I win?
No. Oh. I think we have like 5 minutes.
Dang it.
And if you win because it takes longer, technically we all lose.
Oh. I don't think that's even a thing. If I win, we all lose. I'm just trying to clean out the gunk that somebody put in here. Okay, I'm going to pull out these filter panels. They just slide out the sides, one on each side. That exposes these holes, which are going to be necessary for when the unit's somewhere. Up in there. Yeah, it goes up in there somewhere.
There. Okay, good.
That goes up in there like that. And this like that. This is the part where I'm supposed to be able to see those little clippy doodads again.
Oh yeah. So the thing we unclipped, now we're trying to clip.
Oh.
Oh, we're gonna have to wash that ceiling.
Well, I feel like is that better? Uh-oh.
Is that Did it do something?
I don't know. Nope. Okay. You would think.
Boom. Yeah.
Okay. All right. That's something. Right. I mean, that seemed like positive clickage.
All right. So the pan heads go in these holes that are more in the center. There's four. And then we've got some more like wood screw looking things with the more countersunk heads. And those will go on the outsides. And that would be a bummer right now to just crack this thing in half, wouldn't it?
We would cut the commercial.
Oh, gosh. So we took the bathroom door off to paint it. And the whole time I'm videoing, I'm next to this bathroom. This is next, okay?
Oh, boy.
So bathroom. There's still, I can show you the toilet from here because you can't see most of it in the back. But we did clean up some of the doo-doo that was on the floor. So the next step, we're going to get that toilet out of here and get it the rest cleaned. And I think hopefully by then we can fill up the black tank with some water, soap, borax, something concoction, and drive it around a little bit and then go dump it. Didn't really want to try to hit the state park with it on a Memorial Day weekend either. So
yeah.
Is it done?
Let's flip it on and find out.
Well, I'm just going to state the time.
Uh-oh.
7:32.
What time did you say?
7:30.
I think we got to go get some gas for the generator.
Well, let's test it out and see if we have to go back 10 steps, then you win. But if not, right. I'd say, you know, I was pretty close. All right. So we're going to try it off our generator here.
All right, the generator's running. Let's give it a shot. Test number one. You ready?
Sure.
I think this is the power button.
Ooh,
it does stuff.
24 degrees.
Boy.
Oh, dang. Celsius.
Oh, how about this?
Oh, yeah, that feels nice.
Huh?
We do have a lot of followers or subscribers from outside of the U.S., so maybe we should leave it in Celsius in their honor.
Right. We'll learn the metric system.
I think the U.S. tried that once. Didn't go very well. Everyone tried it for like a month, and they're like, you know what? Too hard.
Right. Right. So now all of our cars are like metric and standard.
Yeah.
We like to use a combination system.
So, I mean, we'll play with the remote a little bit, but basically, like, if we would have had the tools we needed, had read the directions, you know, some basic things like that. Like, this took us just over an hour and a half from with it being on the ground, completely boxed, to being running. So, I feel like it's a doable project, and I'm sure there's more we can do with this. But, yeah, I think overall, success.
Very true. Real Listen. World, we...
Sorry.
I think she sabotaged me on purpose. Real world, though, we've never touched one of these units before. And yeah, an hour and a half. So
sorry. I don't know if that got too loud. Oh, there we go. 76 Fahrenheit.
Oh, man.
I don't know how to, oh, I just hit down and it made it, the fan yeah, go down. Fan. Oh, there we go, look.
Oh boy.
And the same thing, I don't know, can you see on that? It will show, oh, oops, yeah. like a duplicate.
Right. Oh yeah.
It's on there.
Yeah.
Cool. So overall, pretty sweet. And it is really kicking out the cool air. It feels so good.
Well, thank goodness.
It does shoot it this way. Does it? It's shooting.
Oh, yeah. Out. I'm getting the same amount back
here. It doesn't
here.
Come this way or that
no,
way.
No, those are like the air intakes on the sides. And
oh,
then
you
it,
could aim this.
Right.
All right. So good deal.
Christy approved. So there's the completed AC unit from the top. Just like it belongs up here.
All right, so the AC is in. It was a success.
Yeah.
We appreciate you watching. We've got a lot more projects on this camper. We also have another 1973 Holiday Rambler that we're going to start working on.
Untouched thus far.
Yeah, at some point.
But we've got a lot of projects in store. If you haven't seen some of our other videos, go back and watch those. Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment down below, and we'll see you guys next time.
Bye. Bye. Thanks for watching.
Oh,
gave me
enough.
Nothing now.
No, it's the wrong
all
song.
I got.
Not the one I'm thinking of.